Allison, this is Maxie. Oh, the samples haven't arrived yet? I'm so sorry. Hold on just a second. Okay, you know what? They haven't arrived yet because Kate has failed to hire a second assistant, so I'm here manning the phones all by myself and putting out fires. But thanks to you, I will add tracking deliveries to my to-do list. It'll get there today.
Hi.
Hey, you came to see me?
Yeah, I thought we could finish our talk. Unless this is a bad time.
No, no, not at all. Just do it. Okay? Talk?
Yeah, no, I'll go first. You need to let this thing with Elizabeth go.
I will if you will. Bye.
Elizabeth is a friend. And she's a co-worker, nothing more.
That you take out to dinner and you happen to have picnics with on the hospital roof?
The picnic? That was supposed to be for you.
Okay, whatever. The point is that you clearly see her as more than a coworker.
Exactly. She is also a friend. Well, am I not allowed to have friends?
No, you're allowed to have friends, but if she was just a friend, we wouldn't be having this conversation now, would we? I just don't see why you think she's so amazing.
She just... She gets it. She gets me. She understands my research without me having to explain it to her. I don't have to prove anything.
You don't have to prove anything to me either. Look, I already know how incredible you are, and I don't want to lose you, okay?
To Elizabeth?
To anyone. Look, I know I don't always say or do the right things, and I can be selfish, probably. Most of the time, I mean, everything's always about me, right? It's not my fault, though.
You are saying that the way you act is not
your
fault?
No, it's the way that I was brought up, okay? By my mom. I mean, no, she always cared more about her own life than taking care of the people who loved her. I don't want to be like that. I don't want to be like her. I'm really sorry that I blew up about the whole Elizabeth thing, and if you tell me that you guys are just friends, then I promise that I will believe you. And I'd actually like to make it up to you, too.
You would? Wow.
I was thinking maybe we could go out for Valentine's Day, and just no games or anything, just some quality time together.
Yeah, of course. I'm in.
Good.
Yeah?
Because if you said no, I was going to have to kill you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I have another idea. Maybe we could start making it up to each other right now, if you're interested.
Spinelli, the only thing that...
What are you two doing here tonight?
Hi.
Hi.
We just came from an art exhibit, which was amazing, wasn't it?
Yeah, did you just run into each other there, or...
Actually, Elizabeth invited me.
Well, you know that Ewan loves to paint, and he actually is the one who told me about it in the first place, so...
That's great. How romantic. Well, our table's waiting, and I know how excited you were about celebrating a meal for us, so... we'll just let Elizabeth and Ewan get back to their date.
Yeah. Have a great night.
Thanks.
Don't forget the printers will be here in the morning. Like I could forget.
I will make sure she gets back on time. Don't worry.
Thank you. We still need a new assistant. You need to help me with next month's layout, and we need to plan all my trips for Fashion Week.
Mm-hmm. You know, you'd think that she would have a little more empathy considering the fact that she takes all the time that she needs to work on her relationships. I mean, she could at least give me 15 more minutes for... Matt.
Huh?
What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Mm-hmm. Oh. So much for letting go.
What? What?
You keep looking over there.
I'm sorry. Okay, look, there is something about that guy that I cannot stand.
Yeah, maybe it's the fact that he's with Elizabeth.
Oh, come on, just not start that again, please.
Fine. I'll ignore them if you ignore them.